to sing so beautifully. Amen. So, the Bible says, say within himself that I'm going to be like the Most High. I'm going to exalt my throne above the stars of God in the north. And I'm going to be like the Most High. And Jesus said, I saw Satan as he fell like lightning to the earth. And I'm going to show you who threw him out. Threw him out so fast he didn't know what was going on. He was mad. When he hit the earth, he was so mad that he said, woe unto the inhabitants of the earth, for Satan has come down with great wrath. He was mad because he couldn't overthrow God. All right, let's look at Genesis. Let's see what he done to the creation of God, the man, to man. Genesis, the third chapter and the first verse. Genesis, the third chapter and the first verse. What does it say?
Genesis 3 and 1.
Yes.
Now the serpent was more subtle than any beast of the field.
He's more sneaky than any beast of the field. Now imagine now we're talking about deception. Read.
Which the Lord God had made.
Which the Lord God had made. Read.
And he said unto the woman.
Said unto the woman.
Yea.
Yea.
Have God said.
He went to the weaker vessel. Not that she's weak in her mind. But he went to the woman. You notice he didn't go to Adam. I said he didn't go to Adam. He went to Eve. Listen to what it says.
Ye shall not eat of every tree
in
the garden. And the woman said unto the serpent.
The woman said unto the serpent.
We may eat of the fruit
of
the trees of the garden.
We may eat of the fruit of the tree of the garden. Read.
But the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden.
Now the one God made specifically. You can eat all these trees, everything, all the fruit. Eat what you want, but don't touch that one that's in the midst of the garden. It ain't time for you to eat that yet. Are y'all listening? God's got timing. God's got things, time for us to have. And right then, it wasn't the time for them to have the tree that was in the midst of the garden. All right, read.
God has
said,
ye shall not eat of it. Neither shall you touch it.
Neither shall you, don't it? You can't even touch it. I don't even want you to touch it. These are the strict commands of God. How many times did the Lord tell us not to do stuff and we still touching stuff? Stop touching. You can't eat of it and you can't even touch it. Don't even go near it. How many times you told your children that don't touch that? Touch it anyway. No bad kids. Still bad. Read.
Lest you die.
Lest you die.
And the serpent said unto the woman.
The serpent said unto the woman.
Ye shall not surely die.
You ain't going to surely die. What is God talking about? Don't believe that. You won't surely die. Read.
For God doeth know that in the day
he know. Now look, he's telling some secrets. Satan is telling Eve some secrets. He's telling some secrets, what God said. He said, now look, read.
Then your eyes shall be
open. Now go back.
For God doeth know that in the day.
God doeth know that the day that you eat
thereof.
Then
your eyes shall be open.
Your eyes going to be open.
And ye shall be as God.
And you're going to be like God. Knowing that what they weren't ready for that yet. Adam and Eve were like babies, grown babies. They was grown babies. They was innocent. They weren't ready for that type of knowledge. He said, if you eat, no, if you eat of it, you're going to be wise and you're going to be as God. Huh? Amen. You know the old saying is, his eyes, his nose wide open. Amen. Read.
And when the woman saw,
that
the tree was good for food,
and
that it was pleasant,
to
the eyes, and the tree be desired,
lust of the eye, lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. These three things, God said, stay away from it. Read.
And the tree.
To
be desired to make one wise.
She took of the fruit thereof. Disregarded what God said. Disregarded what, the Lord told them. She knew what God said. How many of us know what God said, but we still do wrong? We still touching stuff. Touch not, taste not, handle not the unclean thing. Amen. Oh boy, if I was in the garden and the Lord told me that, boy. Yes, you would. And he's telling you now, you still touching. You ain't no baby. You don't have a baby-like spirit. They was grown babies. Praise the Lord. Read.
She took the fruit thereof.
And did eat. What did she do?
And gave also unto her husband with her. And he did eat.
Wait a minute. You mean to tell me Adam was right there? He said he was with her. Okay. Now God gave Adam the dominion over the garden, over the animals, over everything. You mean to tell me he let his wife, he knew the law. He knew what God said. He let his wife, get wore down. And let the devil deceive his wife right there, and he was there. So I'm thinking that Adam wanted to eat it anyway. Gonna set his wife up. You ain't no man. You set your wife up. Set her up. I guess he thought if she eat it, the Lord wasn't going to do nothing. Set her up.
And the eyes of them both were open.
And the eyes, the knowledge of them was open. Read.
And they knew that they were naked.
They knew that they were naked. They was like babies. A baby don't know they naked. They run around there with their birthday suit on. And they just run around there. Some of y'all don't know y'all naked. Y'all run around here naked. Y'all won't put on the arm of God. Gonna put on the clothes. He said, clothe yourself with light, the arm of light. After they ate of the tree, they found out that they were naked. You know why? Because God, when God breathed into Adam, Adam became a living soul. So when God breathed into Adam, life came into Adam. The light of God went into Adam. It's called the fossa. And when Adam and Eve was in the garden, all they saw was light around them. Are y'all hearing me? When they sinned, the light left. That's how they knew they was naked. They didn't know they was naked. Amen. All right, read.
And they sewed fig leaves together.
They sewed fig leaves together.
And made themselves aprons.
Uh-huh.
And they heard the voice.
Yes.
Of the Lord walking in the garden in the cool of the day.
Uh-huh. God had to come down there. Amen. In the cool of the day. Couldn't come down there angry. You destroyed all of them. Read.
And Adam and his wife hid themselves.
They hid themselves
from the presence of the Lord.
When you sin, when you do things wrong, you start hiding yourself. You're not freely, you're not open, you don't praise God like you used to. You don't worship God like you used to because you're hiding. So they hid themselves from God. Amen. Read.
From the presence of the Lord God.
From the presence of the Lord God.
Amongst the trees of the garden.
Uh-huh.
And the Lord God called unto Adam.
He didn't call Eve, he called Adam. Know why he called Adam? Because Adam had charge of the garden. He didn't say, Eve, Adam, both of y'all come out here. He didn't say that. He called Adam. Amen. Read. Read. Verse 9.
Called unto Adam and said unto him.
Said unto him.
What art thou?
What art thou?
And he said.
Uh-huh.
I hear thy voice in the garden.
I hear your voice in the garden. Read.
And I was afraid.
And I was afraid. Read.
Because I was naked.
I was naked. Mm-hmm.
And I hid myself.
And I hid myself. Now here's the question. Mm-hmm. Read.
And he said. Who told thee that thou was naked?
God said, who told you that you was naked? Who gave you that information? I want to know who told you. You know, I don't want to tell on nobody. I don't want to be no rat. They still say rat. They still say rat. Yeah. Snitches get stitches. I don't want to tell on nobody. Tell on them. If it's putting you in jeopardy, tell on them. I don't know how they're going to feel about me if I tell on them. Well, you're going to be in trouble too if you don't tell them. Aiding in the bedding. Is that right? You're going to be aiding in the bedding. Amen. Read.
Has thou eaten of the tree?
Have you eaten of the tree? Now, it look like God don't know what they did. No, he know what they did. Mm-hmm. Have you eaten of the tree? Read.
Wherefore I commanded thee that thou shouldest not eat.
Uh-huh.
And the man said.
The man said.
The woman who thou gavest to be.
There you go. That blame game going on. It's their fault. The woman you gave me. Huh? Read.
She gave me of the tree.
Gave me of the tree.
And I did eat.
And I did eat. Read.
What is this that thou hast done?
It seemed like Adam would have said, nah, hey, whoa, what you doing? Don't touch that tree. But he said nothing. How many silent men, stuff going on in your home, you says nothing? Okay. Y'all gonna leave me out here. You can't be a man of your house. He was the man of that garden. He was in control of that garden. You can't be a man of your house and not say nothing. I ain't saying holler and scream, throw chairs. I ain't say do that. But command your house. I don't care if she don't like it. Amen. Like it or lump it. But you got to command your house. No, they ain't going over there. Nope, they can't go out there. No, they're not going over nobody's house to spend the night. Done. We're done with that. I don't want to talk about it no more. Oh, you just mean. Okay. Well, I'll just be mean today. But my daughter and my son ain't going nowhere. Not today. I don't know nothing about their parents. I don't know nothing about who in that house. Y'all quiet. You know, I don't know where they going. Until they move out of your house, you still got to have command over that house. Am I talking too loud, Miss Hazel? Miss Hazel? And I'm not saying run around there like you some daggone gorilla. But I'm saying take control of your house. Especially these boys. And women, you take control of them girls. Amen, somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord. No, you ain't doing, nope. Give me your phone. You ain't taking that phone to bed. What you taking to bed for? Anybody calling you? Y'all gonna believe me after a while. It'd be like that one girl, the guy snatched out the window. What's her name, Elizabeth Smart? Y'all think that stuff is a movie. That was real life. Amen. The other black girls is gone because the parents don't have no care anymore. The Bible said they would be without natural affection. They scared they're going to make their child mad. So what? Amen. You got to protect your child. What I read to the coins about their child, man, you got to protect your child. Amen. You got to raise them up. Huh? Give them the word. Amen. When they're knee high to a duck. Is that right? Amen. Until they move out. And even when they move out, you still got to give them some advice. That don't mean try to control them. Once they get 19, 20, 21, 22 years old, you can't control all aspects of their life. Amen, somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord, all over in their apartment, trying to straighten up their bed. Sit down somewhere. That's his apartment. That's her apartment. If they ask you to do it, then that, you know, help you decorate some things all over there like that's your place. Get out of there. Amen. That's being controlling. That's a deception spirit, too. Amen. I don't go to their house and control them. I'm over there pulling their refrigerator open, drinking stuff. Nah. I ain't got no lunch meat in there. Where the cheese at? I'm not doing that. These are grown men and women. I need a key to your house. No, I don't. I don't need no key to your house. Now, if you give me a key, that's something different. But I'm asking for a key to your house. If I get mad at first lady, I'm going to go over there and crash at your house. The chain. I'm down in the man cave over Keith's house on the back porch. You see what I mean? That's stupid. Amen. No, man, you need to drive this car. What kind of tires you got on here? Trying to rule and trying to take over your children's life. I ain't talking about that. I'm talking about when they in your house, they in your rule. And God is going to get you if you don't rule your house like you should rule it. Amen. And the parents, I don't know how we got. Parents, you got to rule together. The daddy can't say one thing and the mama in the background saying something else. You're going to confuse that child. Amen. Amen. They're going to put two against the middle. If daddy said no, it's no. If mama said no, don't let them come to you and say something different. Amen, amen somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord. No is no. No ain't no, yeah. Is that right? Oh, no. Amen. God had to take command of the garden because Adam didn't take command of the house that God gave him. He didn't take command. Amen. Amen. He lost his command of the garden because he let Eve, he was right there. He let Eve take of that tree that God told him not to take of. You destroy your house when you don't let the man be the man. Let me tell you the order. It's God, it's Christ, and it's the man. It's the woman, and then the children. That's the order. Not the woman above God. Stop idolizing your spouses. Stop idolizing your children. They get mad, you say, no, no, they ain't wearing that. They ain't going out of his house with that stuff on. Tell them to take it off. And if she got any sense, she'll go along with what you say. But she ain't got no sense. She ain't going to listen to you. Amen. Adam got in trouble because God gave him dominion over that garden. He didn't call Eve. He said, Adam, where are you? Read.
And the Lord God said unto the woman.
Lord God said unto the woman.
What is this that thou hast done?
The devil has deceived her. The Bible said Adam was not deceived, but the woman. Mm-hmm. You read it. I ain't saying this. He said the woman was deceived. Listen to what it says. Adam, read.
And the woman said.
Woman said.
The serpent beguiled me.
The serpent tricked me. There's that word beguile again. Am I talking about that word communion night? Well, it's supposed to be communion night. Beguile means he said Nathaniel didn't have no deceit in him, no guile in him. He said, she said, a woman, the serpent beguiled me. He tricked me. He deceived me. But, no, he didn't. See, some folk want to hang on like somebody tricked them. No, did nobody trick you? You knew better. You wanted to do it. I can't get no help. You wanted to do it. Did nobody trick you into doing that? You know what God told you to do. We know what God tells us to do. The devil ain't deceiving us. We want to be deceived. We open to be deceived. We open ourselves to be deceived. We know what the word says, but we do it anyway because our flesh calls for it. Amen. He even told her. He said, did not God say? That's and that. And she said, God said, we can't eat of it. She having a conversation with the devil, with the serpent. She knew better. Read.
And I did eat. And the Lord God said unto the serpent, because thou hast done this.
Because you have done this.
Thou art cursed above all cattle.
Cursed above all cattle.
And above every beast
in
the field.
Yes.
Upon the belly shall thy go.
Yes.
And the dust shall thy eat all the days of thy life.
Read.
And I will put
enmity
between thee and the woman.
Yes.
And between thy seed and her seed.
And that's another Bible class right there. Talking about Jesus and the serpent. Jesus and the devil. All right, read.
It shall bruise thy head.
Mm-hmm.
And thou shalt bruise his heel.
Yes.
Unto the woman he said, I will greatly multiply thy sorrow.
That's why y'all have a lot of pain during birth. Because your mama Eve, she did that to y'all. Don't be hitting the man. Squeezing his hand off. He didn't bring that. He did it. Mama Eve did that to y'all. Almost breaking his fingers. Amen. Praise the Lord. Anytime you go through childbirth like that and travailing with pain like that, you better blame her. She the cause of all that. Because when nothing like that going on when it was going on. Okay, y'all missed that. That went on. Y'all get that next week. Read.
In thy conception. In sorrow thy shall bring forth children.
Mm.
And thy desire shall be to thy husband.
Desire shall be to your husband.
And he shall rule over thee.
Not to nobody else, sisters, women, people of God. Your desire shouldn't be to nobody else when you're in the, especially when you're saved. Amen. You shouldn't be looking at nobody but man. He said your desire shall be to your husband. You don't know how he treat me. He said your desire to be to your husband. Read. Well, what about him?
And unto Adam he said.
Unto Adam he said.
Because thou hast hearkened unto the voice of thy wife.
Since you listened to Eve. What did he say?
And hast eaten of the tree.
And you ate of the tree.
Of which I commanded thee.
Uh-huh.
Saying.
Same.
Thou shalt not eat of it.
Now, I told you not to eat of it. And you sat right there and let her pick off that tree. And you said nothing. Read.
Cursed is the ground.
I don't want to hear her mouth. Well, she going to hear mine. No. No is a sanctified answer.
Amen.
No.
Amen.
We ain't doing that. No. We can't afford that. No. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. No, Johnny can't go out. You can't go out to play. Susie can't go outside either. Read.
Cursed is the ground for thy sake.
Uh-huh.
In sorrow. Shall thou eat of it.
He said, I'm going to curse the ground because of you. The ground was bringing up. The ground was irrigated.
Amen.
It never rained. Water was coming up from the ground. Adam didn't have to do nothing. Just watch it. Now he said the ground is going to be messed up because of what you did. How many know there's consequences when you do things against God? Amen. David's whole family was messed up because of what he did. And it came from Jesse, as far as we can go. His daddy. On down through the lines of Rehoboam, Solomon, huh? All his children, Absalom, because of the deceit in that family. You can curse your whole family because you won't be honest. Because you want to be trickery. You want to be full of the devil. Amen.
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Read.
Thou shalt eat. Cursed is the ground for thy sake.
Cursed is the ground for your sake.
In sorrow. Shall thou eat of it all the days of thy life.
Yes.
Thorns. And thistles. Shall it bring forth to thee.
It was bringing up beautiful fruit and veggies and stuff like that. Amen. He said, it's going to be thorns and thistles because you tripping. I'm using my words. Read.
And thou shalt eat the herb of the field.
It said, eat the herb of the field. And he said, smoke it.
Amen.
So he said, eat it. And not that stuff that they smoking. Don't get it twisted. Read.
In the sweat of thy face.
Sweat of thy face.
Shall thou eat bread.
Uh-huh.
Till thou return unto the ground.
You're going to work hard. Brothers, your hard working, blame it on Adam. Adam is the cause of you had to work like a dog. Adam did that. Amen. Don't get mad at your wife because you got to go out there and hit the bricks. Amen. Get mad at, amen, Father Adam. He's the cause of all of our hard labor and stuff. Read. And thus thou art.
And unto thus shall thou return.
Thus you shall return. All right, let's go to Revelation. Satan deceived them, the first couple, amen, on the earth. Satan deceived them into touching and eating the tree that was in the midst of the garden. Can you say amen?
Amen.
Revelation. We was in the beginning of the book. Now we're in the end of the book. Revelation 12. Let's read 1 to, well, let's just read. Revelation, the 12th chapter, first verse.
And there appeared a great wonder in heaven.
Appeared a great wonder in heaven. Mm-hmm.
The moon under her feet.
Yes.
And upon her head a crown of 12 stars.
Yes.
And she, being with child, cried,
mm-hmm,
travailing in birth.
Yes.
And pain to be delivered.
Yes.
And there appeared another wonder in heaven. And behold, a great red dragon.
Great red dragon. Read. The devil.
Having seven heads.
You saw, you see, he was in. He was in Genesis, not in Revelation, at the end of the book. Read.
Having seven heads and, mm-hmm, 10 horns.
Seven heads and 10 horns.
And 7 crowns upon his head.
Mm-hmm.
And his tail drew the third part of the stars.
That's when he deceived the angels up there. The third part of the stars was the angels. Now, how you, tell me something. Tell me this. You looking right at God. You looking at the majesty. Huh? You looking at glory. Mm-hmm. How you let him trick you out of heaven? I said something right there. You looking at glory. How are you letting the devil trick you out of heaven? Amen. They are right there. The angels are right there with God. They let something that God created trick them out of eternity. What I'm saying to you today, why would you let the enemy, why would you let the devil trick you out of salvation?
Amen.
Trick you out of deliverance. Amen. He drew a third of the angels, followed him. They rebelled against God. Some of y'all might say, I wouldn't never done that shit. I'm in heaven too. I ain't hardly going to be doing that. I'm going to be right by the throne of God. Well, they did it. You will too. Yeah, if I was walking with Jesus, boy, I don't know what's wrong with them disciples. Peter denied him. Judas betrayed him. What's wrong with them? They seen all the miracles Jesus did. Man, I'd have been right there. Yeah, okay. Yeah, when they grabbed him, crucified him, they all ran. And you would have ran too for the fear of your life. Because they had a real threat on them. Amen. read.
And his tail drew the third part of the stars
of heaven. His stars of heaven. Read.
And it cast them to the earth.
Read.
And the dragon stood before the woman.
Dragon stood before the woman.
Which was ready to be delivered.
Uh-huh.
For the devour her child.
And this is symbolic to Herod trying to kill Jesus. Now listen closely. This is symbolic to Herod trying to destroy Jesus at his birth. You remember when Joseph left and went down in Egypt? By the time Jesus came back, Jesus was 2 years old. But this is when, this is have symbolic reference to the birth of Christ and the devil trying to destroy Jesus before he gets on his missionary journey. All right, read.
And the dragon stood before the woman.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. For to devour her child as soon as it is born.
Yes.
And she brought forth a man child.
Brought forth a man child.
Who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron.
The rod of iron, read.
And her child was caught up unto God.
Child was caught up to God, read.
And to his throne.
Uh-huh.
And the woman fled into the wilderness.
Yes.
Where she had a place prepared of God.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And really? There was war in heaven.
There was war in heaven.
Michael and his angels.
Imagine now Satan got cast out, but he still had access. Mm-hmm. Check that out. You know why? Just because you got a bad son don't mean he ain't got access to your house to let him in. He's still your son. Just a bad son. You're a bad seed. Amen, somebody. But you're going to watch him when he comes in that house so he won't steal nothing. Amen. You're going to feed. You're going to give him something to eat. You know, you need something to eat, hungry. Because that's your child. You ain't going to put him on the porch. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Do you know that Satan is Michael's brother? Not Jesus' brother, Michael's brother. They're brothers. So he had access. Read.
And there was war in heaven.
There was war in heaven.
Michael,
they about to fight. Michael
and his angels.
Listen, y'all.
Fought against the dragon.
They fought against the dragon. Now Satan, which was Lucifer, the devil, he's a dragon. Huh? They fought against the dragon. He fought his brother. Read.
And the dragon fought.
Uh-huh.
And his angels.
And his angels.
And prevailed not.
And he didn't prevail.
Neither was their place found anymore in heaven.
And God said, "This is it. I'm done with this. Huh? You're out of here. Huh? Amen. Praise the Lord. You already messed up once. Now you don't come up here to try to fight with Michael now. Read.
And the great dragon was cast out.
It was cast out.
That old serpent.
Called the devil.
And Satan. Which deceiveth the world.
He deceiveth the whole world. Now you know right now this world is so deceived, it's crazy.
Oh, yeah.
They're so backwards and deceived. People saying things backwards, they calling good evil, evil good.
Amen.
Amen. They twisting things around, they take words and twist it around. Captain used to be, "I'm talking about your mama." Now Captain mean I'm lying. What's that other word we heard? We heard another word. We said, "How they gonna take that? That ain't what that means." But they're taking words and making it something else. And that ain't what that mean. We used to sit around and talk about each other, Mama. We did that. Cap on each other. And only about one person would get mad. And that whole crowd want to fight. We we playing. You talk about my mama, I ain't get mad. Now I talk about yours, you want to fight. It's just a joke we playing. If you can't play, then stay out the game. But they fought. There was a war in heaven, and Satan, the old dragon, the devil, amen, was cast out of heaven. Read again.
Which
deceived the whole world.
The
word I want you to see that he is a deceiver. Amen. He's a deceiver. Read.
He was cast out into the earth.
Uh-huh.
And his angels were cast out with him.
His angels was cast out with him. Uh-huh.
And I heard a loud voice saying in heaven.
Yes.
Now has come salvation.
Now has come salvation. Now some deliverance can come now because Satan is out. Amen. Read.
And strength.
And strength. Kingdom of our God. Read.
And the power of his Christ.
And the power of his anointing. Read.
For the accuser of our brethren.
The accuser of the brethren.
Is cast down.
Okay. While we're accusing each other. While we're accusing each other of stuff. If the accuser of the brethren has been cast down. So what we pointing fingers? Amen, somebody.
Amen.
Why is the church pointing fingers at one another? When you say the accuser of the brother's been cast down, you should have no association with accusing. Because you're supposed to be saved now. You're supposed to be sanctified now. You're supposed to be holy now. You ain't got no business accusing somebody. Amen, Walt. Talk to me like. Are you listening? You should not be accusing folk of doing stuff if the accuser of the brethren has been cast out. If you're going to accuse somebody, accuse yourself. Point your finger at yourself. You'll feel better when you tell on yourself. Yep, it's me. Yep, all me, it's everything. Amen. Accuse yourself. All right? Read.
For the accuser of the brethren cast down,
yes,
which accused them before our God day and night.
Day and night, read.
And they overcame him.
They overcame him.
By the blood of the Lamb.
They overcame the devil by the blood of the Lamb. And by the words of their testimony. Amen. That's how you overcome the enemy.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
All right, let's look at Exodus. I think that's what I want. Exodus 20:16. This devil is a deceiver. And you got to recognize that he's a deceiver. Whatever is going on is not like God. It's the devil. I think that's what I want. Y'all write this stuff down. You can't keep this in your head. Amen. Because Jesus told, the Lord told John, said, write these things which you hear and see. Write this stuff down because you can't keep it in your head. All right, let's. Let's start at verse 1. I'm sorry, not verse 1. Hold up. Yes, verse 1 of chapter 20.
Exodus the 20th chapter, first verse.
Mm-hmm.
And God spake all these words, saying, I am the Lord thy God.
I am the Lord thy God. You got Bible?
Out of the land of Egypt.
Okay. Read.
Out of the house of bondage.
I brought you out of the land of Egypt and out of the house of bondage. Read.
Thou shalt have no other God.
You shall have no other God before me. Read.
Thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image.
Mm-hmm.
Or any likeness of anything.
Don't make any likeness of anything.
That is in heaven above.
That's in heaven above. Read.
Or that is in the earth beneath.
Uh-huh.
Or that is in the water under the earth.
Don't even make nothing of a fish. All right, so don't do none of that. Read.
Thou shalt not bow down thyself to them.
Uh-huh.
Nor serve them.
Nor serve them.
For I the Lord.
I the Lord.
Thy God.
Uh-huh.
Am a jealous God.
I'm a jealous God. Read.
Visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and fourth generation.
Now see, God wasn't playing back then. See? And he's the same. Yesterday, today, and forever. But he would mess up four generations when folk be tripping. The whole bloodline tore up. See? Read.
Visiting the iniquities of the fathers.
Of the fathers.
Upon the children unto the third and fourth generation.
Now, you get your child in trouble because you tripping. Ain't nobody saying nothing. Amen. God will get your child because you ain't got no sense. Amen, somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord. Put your child in jeopardy. Y'all ain't talking to me. Amen. Y'all ain't talking back to the preacher. You think you're not responsible for your child? You are. They grown. Yeah, they may be grown, but you still can give them some counsel. All right, read.
Third and fourth generation.
Third and fourth generation.
Them that hate me.
Them that hate me. God said, you hate me when you don't do what I tell you. Read.
And showing mercy unto thousands of them.
Uh-huh. I show mercy to thousands of folk that love me.
And keep my commandments.
And they that keeps my commandments. All right, read.
Thou shalt not take the name of the Lord thy God in vain.
Don't you take it in vain?
For the Lord will not hold him guiltless that taketh his name in vain.
Yes, read.
Remember the Sabbath day.
Remember the Sabbath day.
To keep it holy.
Amen. How many know this? The Sabbath day is just on no Saturday? The Sabbath day is every day.
Yes.
To keep holy. Mm-hmm. All right, read.
6 days shall thou labor.
6 days shall you work.
And do all thy work.
And do all thy work.
But the seventh day in the
but Sunday
is the Sabbath.
You're supposed to be in church.
Amen. Of the Lord thy God.
You don't both be working on Sabbath. Sunday. I gotta go to work. No, you don't. You don't work 6 days. Mm-hmm. The seventh is holy. Get your behind in church and sit down. Hallelujah, somebody. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. I worked with Mr. Grader for six days. After 6 days, I ain't coming to Grader's on Sunday.
Amen.
I don't care how much they pay. Amen. Hallelujah, somebody. Amen. Praise the Lord. I don't care about no night shift differential. I don't want the real night shift, the darkness that you can feel. That's the darkness. I don't want to feel that night shift. Y'all missed that. Amen. All right. What did it say?
In it.
Thou
shalt not do any work.
Don't do any work.
Thou nor thy son.
Nor your son.
Nor thy daughter.
Nor your daughters.
Thy manservant.
Thy manservant. Listen to God talking. Thy maid servants,
nor
your cattle. Don't even work your cattle. Let them rest. Nor what?
Thy stranger.
Nor a stranger.
That is within thy gates.
Uh-huh.
For in 6 days.
In 6 days.
The Lord made heaven and earth.
The Lord made the heavens and the earth. The sea.
And all that is in them.
Yes.
And rested the seventh day.
Uh-huh.
Wherefore the Lord.
Uh-huh.
Honor thy father.
Honor thy father. Listen to me, y'all. You better honor your father and your mother.
That
can't be snapping and talking crazy. You get your teeth pulled out your mouth. Honor your father and your mother.
That thy days
may be long upon the land. You want to live long? Honor your parents. You want to die early? Don't honor them. Okay. Y'all going to play with the preacher. You want to live a long life? Honor your parents. You want to die early? Don't honor them. But you don't know how they treat me. Well, praise the Lord. Sit down. You ain't paying no rent. You ain't buying no food. You ain't buying no clothes. Even if you was doing all that, it's still your parents. You don't know your right hand from your left hand at this point. Amen, somebody. You don't even know who you are at this point. Amen. You think you know because somebody outside of the house told you you somebody. You really don't know how you smell. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. You don't know nothing about life. You ain't been around long enough to know about life. You still wet behind the ears. You got milk around your mouth. You have no clue what life is about. Why is I'm going this way? Praise the Lord. Because I got all these young folks in here. Let me go with it. Are you listening? I know what I'm doing. No, you don't. You don't know what you're doing. You don't even know how to pay your phone bill. Hallelujah, somebody. Praise the Lord. You don't know how to wash up. Brush your teeth. Comb your hair. Listen to me. And you want to be grown. Grown means responsibility. Shouldering responsibility. Huh? Putting the whole thing on your shoulders. Am I talking right to anybody? Amen. And handling that stuff too. Huh? You got to be able to handle it. Amen, somebody. Take care of your house. Amen. Pay your bills. Put gas in one another's car. Y'all thought I was going to say put gas in your wife's car. Do both of them. Bless each other. That's how you do it. That's how you stay blessed. You bless each other. Hey, this ain't no one-sided marriage or one-sided parenthood. We help each other. Amen. That's how you do. Huh? All this other stuff is full of the devil. All this other stuff is deceiving. Amen. When you don't work together. When you don't work together, a kingdom divided against itself shall not stand. You're not going to stand. Your house going to break and your house going to fall. Are y'all listening to me? Listen to me, young men, young ladies. Listen to what I'm saying. Once you hit that door and say, I'm out, sometimes you're going to wish to God that you were back in your mama's house. Because you ain't going to be able to eat. Folk ain't going to want to feed you. Your friends ain't going to be your friends when you ain't got no money. You ain't got no end. Is that what they still saying end? You ain't got no butter, no paper. You ain't got no bread. The butter, the bread. You ain't got nothing. Your feet stink. They tired of smelling your feet. Come on now. You ain't got no soap powder to wash your clothes. Y'all better hear what I'm saying. I'll get out of here. Get tired of this old house. Okay, old house got a washing machine and dryer. Old house got a stove and refrigerator. old house got a room that you in that you ain't paying rent for. Get out of my room. This ain't your room. When did you start paying rent? It ain't even your bed that you in. Is that right? Am I talking right? You got to teach these children while they're young. That rebellious spirit, somebody put it in them. Some of their friends, I do what I want to do. Why you can't do what you want to do? And you should respond, because I can't, and I don't want to until I have to. Stop listening to old folk that they ain't got nothing going on. They ain't got nothing going on, and they don't want you to have nothing going on. Don't date a woman that's mean to her mama. Don't date a man that mean to his mama. Or don't obey his parents. Amen. You watch folk when you're dating them. See how they act. I watched my wife. I sat on the garbage can and watched everything she did and how she treated her mother. For 3 years, I watched how they interact one with another. Amen. Praise the Lord. And I found a good one. Amen. You talking about a match made in heaven. God made that match. Because I ain't no A from bullfrog about nothing. You hear me? Didn't get taught by my father how to treat a woman, but some kind of way I knew how to do it. Amen. And I'm still that same way today. I haven't changed a bit. I know how to get out the car and open the door for her. Mm-hmm. You walk in there, I'm slamming the door, I'm all in the car, and she comes to the car. I still open the door for her. Amen. When I'm outside the car. Amen. And some, it's been time since now, I wait till she comes down the steps, knees hurting, all that, and open the door and let her get in. And they, you know, blam. You can't open the door for me? You got a hand, open it for yourself. You're a weak man. Amen. Praise the Lord. I still give her money because she's a good wife. Amen. She gives me money. Some of y'all won't give y'all husband no money. There you go. He said, there you go, meddling now. Yeah, I sure am. I'm meddling. Slide your husband some money sometime. This phone on? Hey, man. We got to deal with the whole ball and wax. It's all of us together. If the home is messed up, the church is messed up. If y'all can't get together at home and get on 1 o'clock at home, y'all gonna come here and mess everything else up. You can't sing over mess. You can't preach or teach over mess. Your home got to be right. Your children got to be right. Teach them boys how to be men, not wimps. Call it a... Johnny, what's going on? Pam, boom, pop, pop. Who's that making all that noise? Throwing stuff, slamming doors. Because somebody can't get their way. First time somebody would have hit me, it would have been over. You don't put your hands on no man's person. It would have been done. I've been married to First Lady Benita Cephas for 50, going on 50 years. I never raised my hand or called her out of her name. Her name is Benita. Her name is not stupid, dumb, crazy. And she never acts stupid, dumb, and crazy. Some of y'all act stupid, dumb, and crazy. Never. I'm not saying because she's sitting there. I never had that problem. I'm trying to get y'all to follow the pattern. These boys never seen me grab their mama and Jacob or smack her. I don't know how far that would go. But that, who you mad at? Who you mad at? What you doing? Why you hitting me? Why you hitting me with your word? Why you talking to me like that? What is wrong with you? Who you mad at? Talk to your daddy. Talk to your mama. Maybe something happened that you mad about. What you mad about? I ain't the one did it. I ain't the one left you. I've been here the whole time. I've been in the fight with you. I've been struggling with you. Why you mad at me? How come I can't get some loving at night? Uh-oh. Maybe I'm going the wrong way. How? Why can't get nothing? And the TV get more than I do. We got to get this thing right, y'all. We're going to wind up being deceitful in everything we do, our life going to be deceitful, the way we think going to be deceitful. Amen. Praise the Lord. Your body is not your own. You can't be holding back on your spouse. That's part of being saved, y'all. Give it up. Turn it loose. Stop all this playing. God going to get you. Amen, somebody. Amen. You cannot hold back on one another for a whole long period of time and expect them to stay saved. Right. Mr. Cohen, you say all the time, we got to help one another stay saved. Right. You say that all the time. You can't be doing that stuff. Putting on old grandma clothes. No, put on a negligee. Nobody want to see that. Sleeping in your pajamas and all that kind of stuff. Praise the Lord. Let your children, not let them see that, but let your children see you loving one another.
Amen.
Let your children see you loving one another. These children know I love their mama. There ain't no doubt in their mind. The church know I love their mama. I ain't doing this because I'm here. I do this when I ain't here. She walked past my chair and rubbed my head. Just be doing it. I ain't studying about you. Oh, man. I'm the grandfather. I go grab her and just hug her and kiss her. Praise the Lord. Because sometimes I know she needs a hug. Y'all don't know how to be romantic. Y'all some unromantic folks. Y'all should be howling and screaming. You gotta know how to be romantic. Romantic ain't always sex, but it's a part of it. Intimacy. What? Come on, girl. Right there talking. Are you listening? Romantic is I go buy her a card and tell her how much I love her. It might not even be no money in it. Hey, y'all looking for money. That's all you got? I thought about you. I bought you a card. You can't have money all the time in the card. It's the thought that counts. How y'all get so unromantic? How y'all get so unromantic? Y'all was all romantic when y'all was dating. Then you shouldn't have been. Touching everything. Wasn't even married touching. And now you get married, get hooked up, and now y'all don't know each other. You in one part of the house, they in the other part. Won't even sit on the couch and watch TV together. And the children looking like, when I get old, I'm going to treat my girlfriend like that. I'm going to treat my girl like that. I'm going to treat my guy like that. See how my dad treat my mama? See how my mama treat my daddy? You're a looking glass for your children. The Bible says be a pattern of good works. Don't be lovey-dovey when somebody gets you something or give you something. Come on now. Love is an action word. Amen. I don't love her because she gives me stuff. She don't love me because I gave her stuff. But we love each other because we're supposed to love each other. For better, for worse. For richer, for poor. In sickness and in health. To death do us part. Yeah. Amen. That's how you're supposed to love one another. You're supposed to love your children. Amen. Amen. Whatever they need, you're supposed to provide for them. Amen. They shouldn't go 3 days without eating. Because you're too lazy to go cook. Give them some cold cuts in the refrigerator then, some bologna. It's a miracle whip, huh? That worked? Well, I'm sorry, Keith, you don't like that. What I'm saying is, have something in there for them. Don't have them sitting up there hungry for 3 days. They ain't fasting.
Come on.
Feed them kids. Amen. Have them all mild nutrition. They can't even fight off colds because they ain't got no beans in them. Don't you got to cook some beans? I mean, like Great Northern beans here. Great Northern beans. Put that slab in there, bacon. Huh? Put them knuckles in there. Come on, somebody. With some cornbread, stick to your ribs. You won't be hungry for hours. I bet half of these kids in here don't even know nothing about Great Northern beans. Because y'all don't cook it. They don't know about hobo meat, lunch meat.
Come on.
And get a bologna sandwich and put some sandwich cookies between it. You with me? You with me, Diggy? You with me? You ain't with me? You ain't with me? I see y'all. Y'all don't know what's going on. And the thing, the Kool-Aid. Oh, now, come on, so now you ain't with me. Y'all remember that? Come on, man. Don't rub me. I'm trying to tell these folk how to survive. We had sugar bread when we was growing up. Y'all ain't saying nothing. And sugar and butter. Now you gotta know how to survive in this life. Man, you ain't always gotta go to the fast food joints. Huh? Put something in the house. I told my wife, I said, get some garlic bologna. And I like it kind of thick, like, you know, and put some cheese on it. Give me some Hawaiian bread. I'm good. You ain't gotta cook no 7-course meal for me. I'm simple. Are y'all listening? I'm a simple man. Peanut butter and jelly sandwich. Huh? I said sandwich. Y'all know what a sandwich is? You put that together and you eat. Get your cold glass of milk and eat. You ain't got to have no steak every night. Huh? Hallelujah. The devil's deceiving you if you think you got to have a four-course meal every night. You got to go to a Longhorn, which is one of my favorite steakhouses. You ain't got to do that. Huh? Get up in the morning and fry some eggs and throw some meat down there and some toast. So Deacon Roper know what I'm talking about. Look, I had a witness there since I've been talking. Huh? Hey, amen. Anybody know about stewed potatoes? Y'all don't know about stewed potatoes? Cut up potatoes and throw them in the pot and stew them up.
Come on.
And some beet potatoes. Onion. Yeah. You got to put all that stuff in there, man.
Yeah.
And then keep them children instead of eating all this candy and junk. Huh? Make them big and strong. Amen. And that'll teach them how to cook and teach them how to, before they get married, they'll know how to cook. I won my mother-in-law over because I fried her some chicken. That chicken was falling off the bone. Huh? Did I not do that? And then when I was working at Frisch's, I was about 20. I think Mikey, was Mikey born? I was about 20, 21. I bought him a chicken dinner. Huh? I always been a gentleman. You got to be a gentleman. Huh? And you teach your sons to be gentlemen. Uh-huh. My sons are gentlemen. I don't care what y'all say. Hallelujah. I taught them to be gentlemen. Amen. Praise the Lord. I said, praise the Lord. Don't let the devil deceive you. I'm trying to teach y'all, my grandsons, how to be gentlemen. Amen.